Right. Shorthand dictation. Shorthand dictation, 88 words per minute, 10 minutes speed, 5 seconds. Now write down. While we have charged the teachers with the greatest responsibility of shaping and molding the destinies of the future generation, I feel we are not sufficiently compensating them by way of proper emoluments and satisfactory conditions of work. I can assure you on my behalf and on behalf of the government that we will strive to improve the conditions of the great teachers so that they can play a more important part in shaping the lives of the youth of the country who will be the builders of the country tomorrow. In our country, we have the age-old tradition of reverence for the acharyas. In fact, next to the parents, the teachers is accorded the higher honor, and the majority of our teachers in the past have taken to their work with a missionary spirit, and in spite of heavy odds and adverse circumstances, they have devoted themselves heart and soul to the task of building a national educational system suited to the aspirations of our people. It has been well recognized that the educational system is to be reconstructed so as to meet the challenges of today. So much so we cannot pursue old methods in the changed situation. If we want to build a brighter and better India, we must make a beginning by having better individuals, and this task is placed squarely on the shoulders of the teachers. Generally, there is a feeling that the best talents are attracted to other professions in view of the fact that there is lack of adequate recognition of the importance of the teaching profession to the extent to which it ought to have. This is stated to be responsible for the deterioration in educational standards. Therefore, one should realize that there is direct relationship between the educational standards and the importance of teaching profession. Unless the talents are attracted to the profession of teaching, there cannot be any improvement in the educational standards. We should also remember that democracy demands discipline on the part of citizens. Unless and until there is discipline, nothing can be achieved. We have to remember time and again that education is the greatest and most powerful instrument of social and economic change by which a democracy establishes, maintains and protects the spirit of equality among its members. The responsibility for making a provision for good education of the children and youth rests ultimately on the society. It must therefore take the necessary steps to see that the best products of the educational system get into the teaching profession. This implies that society should give due recognition and honor to its teachers and also provide them with responsible, reasonable conditions of work and service and adequate academic freedom to leave to them proper scope, initiative, creativity and spirit of experimentation. If it is so, there is no doubt that it will have good teachers to begin with and ultimately good education for your youth. There is an intimate relationship between the competence and dedication of the teaching community on the one hand and the society's awareness of its responsibilities towards the teaching community on the other. The history of education all over the world has shown that as the material rewards of teachers are elevated, it becomes possible to recruit into the profession individuals of quality and with more extended professional training. It is therefore necessary that we should provide to those who are in the teaching side and those who are likely to join the professional training in a variety of fields covered by their day-to-day job. I would again like to assure you that the government will do whatever is possible in the matter of achieving this objective. Dear reader, the fact that you have this collection of a manuscript shorthand reading matter in your hands shows that you are eager to improve your shorthand speed and that you are convinced that one of the methods of improving your speed is to read and read quickly and also loudly well-written shorthand. In an article in the Pitman's Office Training, the benefits that accrue from rapid reading, such as the powers of concentration, alertness, and the acquisition of a good vocabulary, are quoted as necessary for success not only in shorthand writing but also in all walks of life. To become a real high-speed writer, you need to possess something more than the ability to read shorthand rapidly, and that something is a penmanship, the ability to read effortlessly and easily. Good penmanship is the foundation on which high speed rests. Here, high speed should not necessarily be understood to mean speeds beyond 160 words a minute. For a student who has completed 80 words per minute, 100 is high speed. But unfortunately, while learning the theory of the system and even in the speed classes, not enough attention is paid to this fundamental aspect of speed writer. The ascent in the speed ladder in the field of shorthand class for the acquisition of good penmanship. Good penmanship can be acquired by careful study and regular practice, and this should commence even from the early stages of learning the system, the use of pen instead of a pencil in the acquisition of good penmanship need not be overemphasized. With the best wishes, yours.